All right, we are here at the Ballard Kitchen. We are going to create a Blue Apron video, and the purpose of this Blue Apron video is to enter a contest. We are supposed to be cooking the award-winning spice-rubbed pork and sweet red onion and black beans. We are to enter this into the contest, and if we win, we get to spend some time with Brooke Williamson and learn how to cook even better. But for today, we're going to start out with the simple recipe, how easy it is to cook this stuff on your own. It's a great opportunity to have farm to the kitchen without any middleman for your very good tasting Blue Chef dinners. So here we go. What they send you is all of the ingredients. They are exactly the right size for the portions of, in our case, we've got portions for two. And today we are going to be using a pork roast, some black beans, garlic, red onion, and cilantro. Along with that, you get a knickknack bag here that has several things in it. In this particular bag, we have some cider vinegar, we have the spice blend, we have some light brown sugar, we also have honey to drizzle on, and we have butter, two tablespoons of butter. So we're going to discard this. And one thing that I like to do when I cook on the Blue Apron recipes is I discard everything as I go along. That way it keeps everything nice and open and clean. So let me discard some of this right now, and we will get to work. The first thing we need to do is we need to chop up our cilantro. So I've got the cilantro already here. I'm going to chop this up, and then I'm going to find a bowl to put that in. And so we'll just chop this along here. So we've got that chopped up now. So that's our cilantro. And we will get our little bowl out here to put our cilantro in for the moment. And we'll grab one of these and put our chopped up cilantro into that bowl for right now. And everything that we do with Blue Apron is very self-explanatory. And the menu or the directions all right there on the back, exactly what you need to do step by step. Again, Blue Apron. And you can get Blue Apron. You can get your first meal half price. And if you would like to send me a little, if you'd like to send me a little message, I can send you a half price coupon, and five of my friends get it for half price, and I get another one for half price. So we all win. All right, so first thing we've got to do, we've got to preheat the oven to 475. That is being done right now. We need to wash and dry the fresh produce, so we're going to do some work on the fresh produce right now. This onion here, we've got to peel it, we've got to cut it up. Some of it's got to be chopped, some of it's got to be sliced, and we're going to do that right now. So we'll take this and get this started. Clean this off a little bit. We're going to take our knife here. And I'm getting some directions as to what I need to do in terms of making sure I continue to make it into the camera. Karen, my lovely assistant, and also my beautiful wife, is doing the filming today. Give her a hand as you watch. She's doing a great job. We're gonna peel this onion here. Get this nice and cleaned off. Wanna make sure that I don't turn my back too many times to you. So now what we're going to do is clean that off there. Knife off. And clean our cutting board off. So now what we're going to do is we're going to halve the onion here. So we're going to just cut this in half. And so we have that cut in half, and we are going to quarter our onion for use at another time. So this part will be quartered. All right, and we've got about 1-inch sections there. We're gonna put that in another container and hold on to that for a few minutes. That'll be used later. The next thing we need to do is we need to then take this onion, and we need to, this part of the onion, we need to dice this some. So I'm gonna cut it up into some smaller sections so that it'll be easier to dice. And I'll take my chopper again and dice this up. All right, need a little bit more. All right, good. We'll do this side, same thing. All right, so we have that diced up there. We've got a piece here that needs to be diced up a little. All right. Okay, so we have that done. Clean this out quickly. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is put this into another dish. We need a little bit larger dish for this one. And we'll grab one of these bowls here. Put those on the side for the moment.
Close.
This in the bowl, and that will just wait a few minutes. Okay, the next thing that we need to do, we need to peel and roughly chop the garlic, and what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to press it because I like to press the garlic. That works better for me. And we don't have to peel it too much because we get it peeled automatically through the garlic press. And I'll get some of this skin off of here. It calls for only 2 cloves, but we like a stronger garlic taste, and so we will put a little more garlic in there. And that's just a preference that we have in the recipes. And the nice thing about the recipes is you get enough of your ingredients that you can do just about anything you want to do with it. So now we have our garlic here. Again, I'll try not to put my back too many times to you, but let's put some things in the sink here. All right, so I've got a pan here and I will press the garlic. And the nice thing about this garlic press, it's the standard garlic press that you get at your local grocery store or any place that sells home cooking utensils. And we just take this, press, and out comes the garlic. That was a small bit of garlic, so we'll scrape that off, put that in there, pop that out, put another piece of garlic in here. This takes just about any size of garlic. Press that out. Another one. This is an extra large garlic press. And we'll do, I think, one more clove here. All right, very good. So that gives us quite a bit of garlic. And we'll pop some of the skin on it out of there. It also comes with a cleaner where you can take this cleaner and it allows you very quickly to be able to dig the skin right out like that. Boom. And you have cleaned out your garlic press very quickly. Much easier than doing it all by hand and chopping it up. Automates the process a little bit. And we'll clean that out a little bit more later on. But that's good to go. Pop that back in to the handle. Boom. Alright, so we've got our garlic press done for now. We'll clean that up a little bit more later. So set that aside. So we've got our onions, we've got our cilantro, we've got our garlic, we've got our diced onions. The next thing we need to do, drain and rinse the beans. So first we have to open the beans. So we'll open our beans here. There are a couple different ways that you can do this where you drain and rinse your beans. You can take the can and drain them from the can this way. Then you can rinse them in the can. Or you can put them into a strainer and drain them from a strainer. I generally do my rinsing in the can. And these are the black beans. One more time, and we should be pretty good. All right, and now we're going to put these into another bowl. We'll get another container here. These into that container. All right, we'll discard the can. Again, this is live from the Ballard kitchen as we prepare Blue Apron dinner on a Sunday afternoon. All right, the next thing we need to do, we have chopped up the cilantro, we've drained and rinsed the beans, we've peeled and pressed the garlic, we have halved the onion and diced the other half, we've preheated the oven and it just went off, so it's at 475. Now, line a sheet, a cooking sheet with aluminum foil. I did that before, and so that's all set to go. We want to pat the pork so that it's dry. So now we're going to open the bag of the pork and we're going to cut the pork out of its package. Notice that, again, Blue Apron sends premium cut steaks or pork or chicken. As you can see, premium cuts, nothing but the best from Blue Apron. And so I'm going to open this package up and pull the pork out. And I'll just put that for the moment on the cooking sheet, or the cutting board. I will discard my garbage again because that's how I operate here in this kitchen. We will then grab some paper towel and we want to pat it dry with paper towel all the way around. And then after we've patted it dry, and we will also pat the cutting board dry here. Now what we want to do is we want to season it with our salt, pepper, and our spice blend. Now again, Blue Apron sends everything exactly as you need. Here we go with our salt and our pepper. We use Himalayan salt. We like that. We've got our pepper here. We'll grind up our pepper. Get it on all sides. Then we've got our salt. And my wife is talking to me. What is it that you would like, sweetheart?
What's the name of this dish?
What is the name of this dish? This is called, again, the spice rubbed pork. Premium cuts of pork, premium everything. Get enough salt on here. All right, then we need to put the spice blend. And the spice blend, we'll have to cut that open. So we'll grab our scissors here. We'll cut the spice blend open. And we will sprinkle the spice blend onto our premium cut pork. Again, from Blue Apron. We love Blue Apron. We've had some very good meals with Blue Apron. We've used it for the past couple months or so. And again, portions are everything. We get everything we need, everything we want. You can tailor exactly. If you don't like steak, you can get things without steak. If you don't like chicken, you can get your meals without chicken. If you don't like fish, you can get your meals without fish. They will tailor it to exactly what you like. And they have different meals for every single shipment. All right, so we got this all in the spice blend here. Get it nice and seasoned. All right, so there's our spice blend. So, all right, salt and pepper spice blend in a large high-sided pan or pot. Heat 1 teaspoon of olive oil. So let me get that started over here on the oven. Or on the stove, I'm sorry. So we've got the stove going. We're going to heat on medium high olive oil. I kind of guess a little bit at what that teaspoon would be, but about that much. And we'll get that pan ready. It'll be ready in just a moment. While it's getting ready, and that pan's a little in the way, so I'll take that pan out of the way. And we'll heat that up. So while that's getting ready, the seasoned pork and cook, turning occasionally 3 to 5 minutes or until browned on all sides, leaving any brown bits in the pan on the stove. Transfer that to our prepared sheet pan, which again, lined with aluminum foil. Then we are going to also, on that prepared sheet pan, we're going to put the sliced onion and drizzle that. So we're going to take our sliced onion, we're going to add that to, let's see, do I have another bowl here that I can use? I do. So I have a bowl here and I've got my sliced onion. And we're going to take the sliced onion, we're going to drizzle this with olive oil, and then we are going to put some salt and pepper on that, and along with the olive oil. Okay.
Wash your hands.
oil is getting nice and warm over here in our pan. And now we're going to drizzle some olive oil onto this onion. All right, now we're going to take salt and pepper. Salt and pepper in here. We get our salt. My wife is doing some editorial comments about how much I use, but she always likes it in the end. She always loves our Blue Apron dinners that are prepared. I was off for a little bit, and I started doing some of the cooking when I was off and of work, and we haven't looked back since, and I continue to do cooking here in the Ballard kitchen with Blue Apron ingredients. So we're going to get this all mixed up together and coated so that we have the salt and pepper on all of the articles of the onion. Toss to thoroughly coat, transfer to the other side of the prepared sheet pan. So we've got this, take this over to our sheet pan and put this on one side.
You can see what you're doing.
We've got our onions here on one side of the sheet pan. Rinse the hands off. Okay, so we are ready now to take, our pan is set. We've got the olive oil in it again, and it's nice and warm, and it's ready to take our pork. So we've got sliced onion, toss thoroughly coat, transfer to the other side of the sheet pan, roast for 20 to 22 minutes after I get done with our pork here. So I'm going to grab a utensil. Here, that is a little peeler is holding my utensil in. I'm going to grab a utensil that will allow me to be able to turn this a little easier. Make sure again everything's coated now. And we'll drop this in the pan. We're going to do some cooking here. I'm going to sear it for 3 to 5 minutes. I'll turn our timer on. So we're cooking away. So here what's happening is all we're doing in this particular case is browning the surface. It's going to end up cooking completely through when it's in the oven for 22 to 25 minutes using those specific directions from Blue Apron recipes. And we've got about 20 more seconds, and we're going to turn this. We're on medium high. And time to turn, so we're going to flip this over. Notice the browning. We've got some browning there. That's exactly what we're trying to accomplish. We'll cook here for a minute, and then we're going to flip the sides and cook it on the sides. Notice this is a nice, thick chunk of pork. Blue Apron does not spare anything in terms of giving you a healthy portion, but just not too much. It's made specifically for a meal for two. In our case, our daughter is out being a nurse out west, and so she's not eating with us anymore. And our son is off at college. He's not eating with us, so we needed something that would just satisfy the two of us and be perfect portions, and Blue Apron does that. If you have a family, you can get Blue Apron exactly the size of your family. And it gives you some really nice, again, recipes. So now we're going to turn this on its side, and we're going to brown. Notice the browning on that side as well. Do this for a minute. Here the end of it. Here this end of it. And it's just about time to turn it over, get the other side, do this other side. Olive oil is a great cooking oil. And if there's any fond off of the pork, then you want to leave that in the pan, because that will be used later as we cook up some other things to go along with it. Got a couple minutes left to go.
That's good.
My wife likes my cooking. And I'm happy when she's happy with the cooking. So, and notice how, with the heat, how much this pork has now thickened up. So again, you have a nice chunk of pork here. And we'll give this a little bit longer, and then we'll transfer this over to the cookie sheet. Alright, so now it's time for us to transfer over to the cookie sheet, and we're going to roast this. So here we go. We'll take our pan over, and we're going to put this now on this side of the cookie sheet. Okay, set that aside for a moment. We'll shut that off. We'll come back to that. Now, it tells us, again, directions. We're on step three. We're almost done with step three. Place the sliced onion noodles bowl, drizzle it. I already did that. Transfer to the other side of the prepared cookie sheet after we've put this on the one side. And we are going to roast for 20 to 22 minutes, or until the onion is tender when pierced with a fork and the pork is cooked through. And it's time to put it in. And it also says if you have an instant read thermometer, you can put that thermometer in. It needs to register at least 145 degrees. Then remove it from the oven. Transfer the roasted pork to a cutting board. Let rest for 5 minutes. Drizzle the roasted onion with half the vinegar. Half the vinegar, and carefully stir into coat. All right, so we'll put this in here right now, and this is going to cook for 20 to 22 minutes, so we'll put it right now for 21 minutes. And start that going. All right, now, what are we going to do next? Well, now, while that is cooking in that 20 minutes, we're going to caramelize the diced onion. So while the pork and onion roast in a small pot, heat the butter. That's from Creekside Creamery. We're going to heat this butter and let it heat until it's melted. So I'm going to take this pan here, and we will put this again on the medium high. And after this is melted, we're going to add the diced onion, season with salt and pepper. So let's go ahead and put the butter into the pot, and you can get a picture of that, the butter going into the pot. Then Once that butter is melted, we're going to take the onion, we're going to put the onion in, and we're going to cook and stir occasionally for 3 to 4 minutes until it's lightly browned and slightly softened. Then we're going to add the brown sugar, a half cup of water, so we need to get our measuring cup out. We'll get a half cup of water ready while we're waiting for that to melt. So we have a half cup of water. Is that melted? Not quite yet. So we'll let that continue to melt, and it'll be melted down in just a minute. Okay, if you have any questions, you can certainly make any comments you want at this YouTube video site that this video is posted on. And we'd love to hear from you if you like the way that we cooked. And if you have any questions about Blue Apron, again, you can get a Blue Apron coupon to get Blue Apron for half price on your first meal. And I'll gladly send you a link for that. All right, this is almost ready to go. A little bit more. It's melting fast now. And here we go. It's looking good. By the time I get the onions over there, we should be set to go. All right, we are set to go, so we're going to pop the onions in here, and we will start stirring this, and this is going to be, again, per the instructions, that'll be 3 to 4 minutes. So it's at 17 minutes right now, 17:54, so we will go for 3 minutes. That'll take us down to 15. And we will keep stirring this. Again, we want it to be a little browned, little tender, not too much. So we want to stir this and watch it. Notice the butter is cooking into the onions. And again, this is a Blue Apron recipe. And this is part of the video challenge, cooking in the Ballard kitchen. Let that set for a minute and get a little round. It smells good. We're 1.5 minutes into it. We got another 1.5 minutes or so. Again, we want it just browned. Got 1 minute to go. And if you want to take a peek down here, we've got the oven roasting there, again 475. It's cooking up nice. All right, so now the next step in that process is to add the brown sugar and a half cup of water. So I grabbed the brown sugar here. Notice they're in these bags that have a little zip tie on it, or I'm sorry, it's perforated and it's got the auto close, but we will just be using this much light brown sugar, and we're going to dump this in here. We'll dump it all in there, and then we're going to add our half cup of water. So now we have a half cup of water. We've got our light brown sugar. We're going to cook now for 11 to 13 minutes, or until thickened and saucy. So we're going to have this cook away. It's got to be thick and saucy. Oops, splashed it a little bit. Okay. So we've got 14 minutes left, and we want 11 to 13 minutes, so that means we'll have our clock down to between four and one minutes. Actually, I should say 3 and 1 minutes. And now,
are you supposed to add black beans to that or no?
No. Okay. Now, while this is caramelizing, I'm going to heat up this pan here. So we'll turn this back on. And and we're going to heat this pan. We're going to add a little more olive oil. We're going to put the garlic in, some salt and pepper. And we're going to then add the beans. So we'll grab our garlic here. We may have enough olive oil in there already, so we can go ahead and add our garlic. And we need some salt and pepper. Some seasoning again. Okay. Salt got a little oil on it. Clean that off a little. And grab some pepper. Same thing. Put some pepper in here. All right, and we're going to roast this garlic. All right, now we have cooked for one to 1.5 minutes, and we're putting the beans in. So now we've added our beans to the garlic. The garlic just was to be for the aroma. And we need to season with salt and pepper. So I'll grab my salt and pepper here. And then we've got 3 to 4 minutes of cooking of the beans. All right, so we have been 3 to 4 minutes here with cooking the beans, and they're supposed to start breaking down, which is exactly what's happening here. So now the next step is to add the honey, half of the vinegar, and half a cup of water. And so I have my honey here. It's in a little pouch. It has a little top that automatically breaks off or tears off when you break the seal. And so we'll just squeeze this out from the pouch. Work it down. I like getting every possible drop I can out of honey, and so I'm going to just kind of work it down slowly. Into the pan here. All right, then I've got a half inch of vinegar. Right here, half of the vinegar, which would be down to about that spot. Put the vinegar in. And that's about right. And then a half cup of water, which is right here. All right. Season with salt and pepper again. All right. And we're going to do this now from 5 to 7 minutes, which we've got almost 5 minutes. Got four minutes left with the pork that's in the oven, so we'll be cooking this for about a minute or so after the pork in the oven is ready to come out, and we want to just stir this occasionally. Now, our caramelized onions are right here, and those are pretty much done, and we're going to turn the heat off here on this, and we're going to season with salt and pepper. So we'll let that sit there for a moment. We'll put some pepper and some salt into that. All right. Back to our beans. Got 2 minutes left of the cooking in the oven. That cook and that. Pretty much that just evaporates the water and brings it down to more of a paste. Three quarters of the water needs to be taken off. Add a little bit more. Actually, the water is evaporating a little bit faster, so that's okay. I'm going to move this off of here. Alright, the liquid is down, so we're going to go ahead and turn that off. And Now what we're going to do, and the oven's going off here, so we're going to check on our pan that's in the oven. Pull that out. And there is our roasted pork and our roasted beans. We'll put that up here for right now. Turn off the oven. And we're going to take the roasted pork, clean off our cutting board. Turn the fan off for now because it's probably too loud. May not have been able to hear me, but hopefully you have, even with the fan on. We're gonna take our pork and let it sit here for 5 minutes. In the meantime, we're going to transfer our caramelized onions into our pan here. Into the pan of beans. So that's done. And we're going to stir and combine that. We're going to add the vinegar onto our onions here. And we're going to stir that in. So that it gets coated real nice with the vinegar. Then we're going to add some more salt and pepper. Not too much, just enough to add a little more to the taste. Okay, again, coat that all in. We've got 5 minutes. We've been doing this for about a minute, so we're going to have 4 more minutes for the pork to set up before we cut it. All right, that's ready. And then we're going to stir this in. Stir this all up. And I'll tell you, this will taste very, very good. I have not been disappointed with any of the Blue Apron meals. And we've had them now for a few months. And it's very easy. Anybody can do this. All you need is a stove, an oven, and a few cooking utensils, and you're good to go. Salt on here. Mix it in. And one last thing we have to add here is the cilantro. So we'll grab some cilantro right now. Want half of it. All right, we're back here. It's been 5 minutes. We're ready to slice now the meat here across the muscle line. So we will just thinly slice our meat like so against the grain. Very juicy. That's what you want. You want it just juicy enough. And we'll slice down one more slice here, like this. All right, so now we have the meat sliced up. We've got 6 pieces. That'll be 3 pieces per person, which is plenty. We have our beans here, which are now done, and they've got the cilantro in them. And the final thing is to divide the finished beans, top with the sliced pork, top it with the roasted onion, and drizzle it with some garlic. I'm sorry, with some olive oil. So we'll put the beans on here first. So we divide this up, half of the plate, like so. And half of it. Half and half. We'll take the pork. Three pieces of the pork. One, two, three. One, two, three. We'll get the onion over here. We'll divide the onion up in half. So we'll put half the onion. That looks like about half. Topped. Another half. And then you can discard the foil paper. That keeps the pan nice and clean. And the last thing we need to do is to get our cilantro. Top the remaining cilantro on, cilantro on, couple knives, couple forks, there you go, the finished dish. Again, we have been cooking in the Ballard kitchen. We have been cooking the spice rubbed pork. It is from Blue Apron, and we are just so happy to be representing Blue Apron in the Ballard kitchen. Thank you for watching.